Hello, welcome to Evancing Academy. Today we are going to discuss application of trigonometry. We have already discussed about the angle of elevation, angle of depression, and we have already discussed about concept of angle of elevation and angle of depression, and moreover the relations between sine, cosine, tangent and cotangent. So today we are going to discuss some questions, simple questions on the basis of that. So let me discuss few more questions today. First question I am writing here today, that the angle of elevation of the top of a tower is 60 degrees. If the tower is 16 root 3 meter high, then what is the distance of observer? What is the distance of observer from the foot of the tower? To see this question, the angle of elevation of top of a tower is 60 degree. If the tower is 16 root 3 meter high, then what is the distance of observer from the tower? So in this question, height of the tower is given, and we have to find the distance. In previous question, what we have discussed, that the height of tower is to calculate it, but distance was given. In this question, height of tower is given. So we can say, let AB be a tower, and O is the point of observation. O is the point of observation. Right? AB is the tower, and O be the point of observation. This is a tower. AB and O is the point of observation. The height of tower is given 16 root 3 meter. This is the height of tower, and we have to calculate the distance of observer from the foot of the tower. This distance say x, and that we have to calculate. The angle of elevation from the observer to the top of tower. So angle of elevation is from, when we are seeing from, we have discussed this, downward to upward, the angle of elevation is the angle made by the observer is the angle of elevation, and that is given what? 60 degree. So I can write here 60 degree. Now we have to think again that for this angle, this is called perpendicular, opposite side, and this is adjacent side, as the side opposite to right angle is always hypotenuse. So this is opposite side and this is adjacent side. Relation between opposite side and adjacent side is nothing else but tan theta. So I can write here tan theta is equal to 16 root 3 divided by x. If I took BC, let BO is equal to x meter. So I can write here tan theta is equal to 16 root 3 upon x. And theta is what? Instead of theta, it could be 60 degree. Tan 60 degree is root 3. 16 root 3 upon x. Now root 3 x is equal to 16 root 3. And now root 3 can be cancels. X is equal to 16. Because root 3 will come this side, it will divide. So x is equal to 16 meter. That is the distance of tower from observer is 16 meter. This is the answer. So this is one question. Now let me another one question is, a kite is flying, horizontally at the height of 200 meters above the ground. And makes an angle of 30 degrees with the horizon. Horizon means plane level. Horizon. Find the length of string. Length of string paid off. This is what? Question is here that a kite is flying horizontally. This is a kite, say, and this kite is flying horizontally in this direction, say like this. And this is the string which makes an angle of, this is the height from the ground level, and string makes an angle of 30 degrees with the horizon. This is the string which is no slack. It is written in the question, there is no slack in the string. There is no slack in the string. This is written here. No slack in the string. Means string is always straight. This is the horizon. This is the level, ground level. And this is the ground level. And you know, and we can say, and kite is flying here, and this is horizontally, kite is moving away, and here the observer is there who has a role, and in which the string is being paid off, a string is coming out. So this length you have to calculate. This is the length of the string that you have to calculate. Height of the kite above the ground, that is 200 meter. This is what given, 200 meter given. For this angle, this is a perpendicular and this is a hypotenuse. This length is perpendicular, side, opposite side is always perpendicular, and right angle, opposite side of right angle is always hypotenuse. So which is the relation which will exist between perpendicular and hypotenuse? Which relation exists? Sine. So sine 30 degree is equal to, sine 30 degree is equal to 200 P perpendicular upon hypotenuse, that is L. And sine 30 is nothing else but sine 30 is 1 by 2 is equal to 200 divided by L. Now if I multiply, cross multiply, L into 1 is L and 2 into 200 is 400 meter. So length of the string is 400 meter. 400 meter length of the string is being paid off from the reel, and you have remembered this, sine 30 is 1 by 2, remember the table now, right? So sine 30 is 1 by 2 and 200 by L, so we can multiply by cross multiplication, L is equal to 400 meter, and therefore length of string paid off is 400 meter. That is answer. Right? So this is the type of questions which we have to find two things. One thing that what is given, and second thing that what we want. What you have to find out. The relation between these two, either sine or cosine or tangent, any one of the three will be applicable definitely, and accordingly the merit of the question you will apply, whether it is sine x applicable or cos theta applicable or tan theta applicable. So in first question here tan theta is applicable, in second question there is sine theta applicable, in some other question might be cos theta also applicable. So let me write some other questions. Write another question. Let me write third question. Third question. Now, a ladder of length. A ladder of length 50 meter rests against a vertical wall. Vertical wall in a straight. Length of 550 meter rests against a vertical wall in a street. The angle of elevation. The angle of elevation of the foot of ladder. Foot of ladder. Ladder makes with the ground is 45 degrees. Find the distance of foot of ladder from the wall. Right? This is the question. To solve this question, I can write here that solution. A ladder rests against a vertical wall. Say this is a wall. You can say like this. This is a wall. Right? This is a wall. And this wall has a ladder. This is a ladder. Say this is a ladder. Length of ladder is 50 meter. This is given. So this length is 50 meter. And you have to calculate this ladder makes with the ground. What the angle they make? 45 degrees. And you have to calculate the find the distance of the foot of ladder. That is this. This is the foot of ladder from the wall. This is the wall. So this distance you have to calculate, say x. We can write again. Let A, B is the wall, height of the wall, and C is the point of observation. Let A is the point, A be the point on the wall where ladder touches the wall. Okay? And C is the point of observation. And C is the point of observation. Point of observation. Observation. Right? C is the point of observation. So you have to calculate here that tan, which what to be calculated? Let BC is equal to X. BC is equal to X meter. Okay. Now, for this angle, this is a perpendicular. Side opposite is always perpendicular. And this is always hypotenuse. And this is what? Base. So, base to be find out. And hypotenuse is already given. Base is find out. And hypotenuse is given. So, which relation to be applied? Which relation will satisfy between or which relation deal with base and hypotenuse? That is nothing else but cosine. Sona Chandi Tole Pandit Badri Prasad Harha Bole. Remember this na? So cos theta is applicable. Sona Chandi Tole Pandit Badri Prasad Harha Bole. So you remember this? Base upon hypotenuse deal with cos theta, cosine only. So we can write here cos 45 degrees equal to x upon base upon hypotenuse, that is 50, and you know cos 45 is what? 1 by root 2, that is x by 50, and therefore x is equal to 50 by root 2 meter. That can be answer. But some people may not like root in denominator, so they can multiply by root 2 both the sides. So what will happen in that case? 50 root 2 divided by root 2 into root 2, 2. So 2 cancel this, and therefore 25 root 2 meter, that will be answer of this question. So foot of the point of observation from the wall, foot of the ladder from the wall is 25 root 2 meter. I hope you got it, right? So let me write some other question. Question is similar like a ladder makes an angle 60 degree with a vertical wall in the street. If the foot of ladder is 20 meter away from the wall, find the length of ladder. Why I am writing again and again the similar question? Because there is some chance of mistake, there is some lack of understanding among the students. That is why I am writing this question what they usually understand. So solution of this question can be like this. Here ladder makes an angle of 60 degree with the vertical wall. So there must be a vertical wall. This is a vertical wall, I say, and this is the ladder. You know, similarly, this is the ladder. This is the position of ladder, and this is the vertical wall, I say. And you can write here, make the wall as well. This is like this, and here it will be like this. So this is a wall, and on wall, this makes an angle of, usually what the students do, they take this angle 60 degree here. But it is clearly written in the question. They makes an angle of 60 degree with the vertical wall, and ladder and wall touches here only, so that angle must be 60 degree. You must write here, this is the 60 degree angle, and if one has written this 60 degree, then definitely they will get wrong answer. So be aware with the language that is written here. Ladder makes an angle of 60 degree with whom? With the wall, and this is the wall. Ladder touches here only, so wall makes an angle of 60 degree there. In the previous question, it was written that ladder makes an angle of with the ground. Ladder makes an angle with the ground, and here ladder makes an angle with the wall. So that is why 60 degree here need to write. Now, the foot of ladder is 20 meter away from the wall. So this is the foot of ladder, this is 20 meter away from the wall. And what we have to find? Find the length of ladder. That is, this one we have to calculate. Say, this one is x. Let me write, this one is l. Now for this angle, this is what? Perpendicular or hypotenuse or adjacent, what is that? Will you tell me? Side opposite to acute angle is always opposite side. This is a perpendicular. If I can write this is A, this is B, this is C, then sine 60 is equal to this is perpendicular BC upon what? AC. That can be written as sine 60 is root 3 by 2 is equal to BC is 20 and AC is L, that we have to calculate. So now, by cross multiplication, root 3 L is equal to 20 into 2 is 40 meter, and therefore L is equal to 40 upon root 3, that is 40 into root 3 divided by root 3 into root 3, and therefore 40 by 3 into root 3 meter. That can be written as, or if you want to write in more simplified way, you can write it 4.732 upon 3. But remember, that will give only a prox value, so it will be better to write answer like this only. Right now? Or if you write like this, then you have to write this approx. 4 to 8 and 4 3 to 12. So 2 carry 1 and 17, 4 to 68 and 169 divided by 3. So 6.938, 69.280 or 69.28 divided by 3, that is 23.09 meter approx. That will be the answer. Right now? So that will be the answer. In that way you can calculate this, right? So let me write some other question of different type. Question number 6 here, or 5, question number 5 today. Question number 5 is, the angle of depression of a car from the top of a tower on the ground is 60 degree. Find the height of tower if the car is at 150 meter away from the foot of tower. Right? This is the question. Angle of depression. It means here, let me write solution. Angle of depression, this is a tower. Angle of depression will make when there is, you know, this is a car. This is a car. Angle of depression made from when we are seeing from top to bottom. Line of sight to be depressed. If line of sight is like this and it's just depressed, then angle of depression means person must see from upper level to lower level. Then angle of depression. So observer is here only. You know, OA is tower, O is the position of observer, and here he is seeing at this way. But when he has to see this car, his line of sight will depress from this point to this point, and then he will be able to see this. So to see this car, his angle of depression will be 60 degree. This is what is given in the question. Now it is also given that car is the height of the tower if the car is 150 meter away from the foot of tower. Car is 150 meter away from the foot of the tower. And what we have to find? Find the height of tower. So this height you have to calculate. Say this height is h. Right? This height is h. So this you have to calculate. As we have discussed earlier, the angle of depression is same as angle of elevation. So that will be also 60 degree. Now for this angle, that would be perpendicular and this will be base. And which relation defined between perpendicular and base? Remember? Do you remember na? Okay. So what is that relation? Of course tan theta. So tan 60 degree is equal to, what is that? H divided by 150. Tan 60 is root 3. h divided by 150, so h is equal to 100 and root 3 meter. So height of tower is, what? 150 root 3 meter. That will be answer of this question. I hope you got it right now. So angle of depression, when we are observing from top to bottom, then what is my angle of depression? And that we have to calculate. Now let me write one more question. To say this, angle of depression. Now, the angle of depression, of the top of a building, from the top of a tower is 45 degrees. Find the difference between height of tower and building or question can be, tower is how long, how many meter more than the height of building. So to solve this question, we can solve it like this. Again, the similar situation, this is a building. I can write this is a building, and the building is this, and tower is this. Of course, tower is higher because we are seeing from tower, from top of a, the angle of depression from top of a building, from the top of a tower. From where from? From the top of a tower. So tower is, depression is made from the top of a tower. So observer sitting here, and he is just observing this top of a building, and that height you have to calculate how long the tower is higher than the top of building. So let the difference of this is h. This we have not to find the complete height of the tower, but we have to find what is the difference between height of building and height of tower. So building is this height, tower is also this height. This is the more height what tower has as compared to building. This angle of depression is 45 degrees, and we have anything else is given? No, we have nothing given. So in that case, how can you calculate? One more information is required. Say, distance between, here it is given that, say distance between tower and height is 30 meter. Distance between tower and height, tower and building, is 30 meter. 30 meter, okay? So that will be 30. Now 10, 45 can be calculated easily. This is 45, that will be also 45. Now using this fact, we can write tan 45 degree is equal to h by 30. Tan 45 is 1, so 1 h by 30, and therefore h is equal to 30 meter. That would be answer to the question. So tower is 30 meter higher than the building. That you have to calculate in this question, and I hope you got it right. So this is the question, how to deal with such question. In next video we will discuss some more question, right? Thank you.